In this series of figures and graphs, we want to look at the factors affecting glomerular filtration and then peritubular capillary reabsorption. At the top here, we have an anatomical schematic showing on the left glomerular structures and on the right the peritubular capillaries that would surround the nephron segments. At the bottom, we have a graphic which is showing essentially the factors affecting bulk flux, JV, which is either filtration or reabsorption as dependent upon the driving forces. And that bulk flux equals Kf, the leakiness coefficient, times the net pressure, the net filtration pressure, determined by the balance between the hydrostatic and the oncotic pressures tending to drive fluids in or out of those capillaries. Now, just for reference, the kidneys in total receive about 900 liters per day of renal plasma flow. That is an enormous amount of plasma flow to structures this small. In addition, we filter about 20% of that plasma flow into the nephron. That equals about 180 liters a day. Remember, we only have 2 to 3 liters of plasma, which means our plasma is filtered over and over and over again throughout the day. And then look over on the right here. That's going to generate only 1.5 liters per day of urine flow, which contains all of our wastes and allows for our electrolyte regulation and maintenance of nutrients within the bloodstream, all those factors that get filtered at the glomerulus. And so how do we generate this both enormous filtration at the glomerulus as well as enormous reabsorption over here at the peritubular capillaries? And so let's go down to our graphic down below here. And what we're going to show you is the net hydrostatic pressure relative to the net oncotic pressure in both sets of capillaries. Now on the left here in the glomerulus, you can see that the net hydrostatic pressure is higher than the net oncotic pressure. Well, that net hydrostatic pressure is dominated by PC, the capillary blood hydrostatic pressure. There is a Bowman's capsule hydrostatic pressure that would be tending to oppose filtration, but it's certainly dominated by this blood hydrostatic pressure outward. Now, the oncotic pressure is dominated by PiC. PiC is due to the plasma proteins trapped in the bloodstream, and they do not get filtered. As you can see, our PiBC, due to plasma proteins that get filtered, equals zero. Almost none of them get filtered. And so we have a reabsorptive force that is overwhelmed by a filtrative force, this PC. And so we end up with net filtration from end to end in our glomerular capillaries. Because of this enormously high Kf, that filtrative force will drive a huge amount of filtration, this 180 liters a day, into the glomerular capsules and into the nephron. Now, in between the capillary beds, we have the efferent arteriole. We continue to get a pressure drop. Notice our hydrostatic pressure, net hydrostatic pressure, will fall as we traverse the efferent arteriole. Our net oncotic pressure doesn't change nearly as much, and that's because there is no filtration or reabsorption in the efferent arteriole. However, we do now have proteins in the interstitium over here, as opposed to Bowman's capsule, which has none. And so our net pressure, the difference between the two, does change slightly. Now, but what we see is that due to filtration, our proteins became more concentrated. We actually went up from 25 on the inflow end to 31 on the outflow end. Remember, that's a reabsorptive force. But in addition, look at our PC, our capillary hydrostatic pressure, fell dramatically. And so now what we have is a dominant blood oncotic pressure driving net reabsorption across those, again, fenestrated capillaries, driving massive reabsorption of almost the entirety of this 180 liters a day, right? We're going to reabsorb 178.5 of those liters to generate our 1.5 liters per day of urine flow.